Hi everyone, I would like to welcome everyone to today's class. Today we are learning about the Coulomb's inverse squared law and scalar form, the similarities between Coulomb force and gravitational force, and differences between Coulomb force and gravitational force. This is electric charge and electric field part 2. Okay, first let us discuss about the meaning of Coulomb's inverse squared law. So according to Coulomb's inverse squared law, the magnitude of force of attraction or repulsion between two point charges at rest, that is actually directly proportional to the product of magnitude of the two point charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two point charges. So this is a statement of Coulomb's inverse squared law in scalar form. So listen to me, the statement once again, this is very important. According to Coulomb's inverse squared law, the magnitude of force of attraction or repulsion between two point charges at rest is directly proportional to the product of magnitude of two point charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Coulomb force is always acts along the line joining the two point charges. It may be attractive, repulsive, that depends on the nature of point charges. If they are like point charges, repulsion will take place. If they are unlike point charges, attraction will take place. So according to the first part of the statement, F is directly proportional to the product of magnitude of two point charges. Suppose if the magnitude of two point charges increases, Coulomb force increases. The magnitude of two point charges decreases, Coulomb force also decreases. Okay, how does the Coulomb force depends on the magnitude of two point charges? One word answer, that is directly proportional. Okay, and Coulomb force is inversely proportional to square of the distance. This is according to the second part of the statement. F is inversely proportional to square of the distance between two point charges. Actually, point charges means charges whose size is very small with respect to their separation. So that is the meaning of point charges. So Coulomb force is inversely proportional to square of the distance. The separation between two point charges decreases, Coulomb force increases. If the separation between two point charges increases, Coulomb force decreases. Now combining equation 1 and equation 2, then we will get F is proportional to Q1 into Q2 divided by R squared. Remove the proportionality, we will get here the proportionality constant KK is constant of proportionality. That is called Coulomb's constant, that is also called electrostatic force constant. The Coulomb's constant, electrostatic force constant depends on the two very important factors. Number one, the system of units used. Number two, the medium existing between two point charges. Number one, the system of units used. Number two, the medium existing between two point charges. So in SI system, when two charges are in vacuum or air, then the value of K is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Epsilon is the permittivity. Permittivity means ability the medium or material, here vacuum or air, to permit the electric free lines to pass through it. That is the meaning of permittivity. So epsilon naught means the absolute permittivity of free space, and this value is 8.854 into 10⁻¹² coulomb square per newton meter square. So this is the SI unit of epsilon naught. One more unit is also there, that is the farad per meter. Farad per meter or coulomb square per newton meter square. That is the unit of absolute permittivity of free space. Now substitute the value of epsilon naught in this equation. So after simplification, we will get 9 into 10⁹. It means 1/4 epsilon naught value is 9 into 10⁹. So finally, the equation becomes F is equal to the value of K is 1/4 epsilon naught. This is an SI system. So into Q1, Q2/R², 1/4 epsilon naught value, which is 9 into 10⁹. And this is measured in terms of Newton. So this is a mathematical expression for the Coulomb force when two charges are placed in vacuum or free space or air. Now, if the charges are in a medium, for example, glass, water, means in between two point charges, the glass is there or water is there. So then the expression of Coulomb force changes. That is F is equal to 1/4 epsilon Q1 Q2/R². The epsilon is absolute permittivity of the medium. That means the ability of medium to allow the electric field lines to pass through it. So this is the expression for Coulomb force between two point charges in the presence of glass or water, in the presence of medium. So note the first very important point, that is the direction of force is always acts along the line joining the two point charges. It may be inward or outward. It may be attractive or repulsive. That depends on the nature of two point charges. And Coulomb's law of electrostatics holds good. That is only for stationary point charges. Actually, there is a limitation of Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law holds good only for stationary point charges. It is not universal because it depends on the presence of the intervening medium between two point charges. Number one, Coulomb's law holds good only for stationary point charges, and this is not universal because it depends on the presence of the intervening medium between two point charges. And this is the SI unit of permittivity, coulomb square per newton meter square. So it can also be expressed as farad per meter. So we know that according to Coulomb's law, the force between two charges Q1 and Q2 placed in vacuum or air or free space, then we will get the expression FV, that is equal to 1/4 epsilon naught Q1 Q2/R² when the same two point charges are placed at the same distance in a medium like glass or water. And then the force between two point charges, that is equal to 1/4 epsilon Q1 Q2/R². So here epsilon is called absolute permittivity or just permittivity of the medium. So dividing equation 1/2. So then we will get FV divided by FM, that is equal to 1/4 epsilon naught Q1 Q2/R² whole divided by 1/4 epsilon Q1 Q2/R². Here 1/4, that is get cancels, and Q1 Q2 is also cancels, R² is also cancels. The remaining thing is 1/4 epsilon naught whole divided by 1/4 epsilon. So 1/4 epsilon is shifted to the numerator, then we will get epsilon/εo. So the ratio of absolute permittivity of the medium the absolute permittivity of space, the ratio of absolute permittivity of the medium to the absolute permittivity of free space. This is called a dielectric constant or the relative permittivity. For air, that value is 1. Because for air medium, epsilon is equal to epsilon naught. The epsilon naught divided by epsilon naught get cancels and that becomes 1. So that is why the value of epsilon or dielectric constant or relative permittivity for air medium is 1. For water medium, that is 80. For metal, that is infinity. Okay. Next, similarities between Coulomb force and gravitational force. Both forces are central forces. The gravitational force acts along the line joining the two particles. Even the Coulomb force is also acts along the line joining the two particles. So that is why both forces are central forces and both obey inverse equator. The expression for Coulomb force is F is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R squared. That means Coulomb force obeys inverse equator law. And the expression for gravitational force, F is equal to G M1 M2 divided by R squared. The F is also inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Gravitational force is also inversely proportional to square of the distance between two particles. So that is why both Coulomb force and gravitational force obey inverse square law. And both of them are long range forces. And both forces are conservative. That means neither be created nor be destroyed. And finally, the differences, dissimilarities between Coulomb force and gravitational force. Electrostatic force may be attractive or repulsive. That depends on the nature of two point charges, but the gravitational force is always attractive in nature. Electrostatic force may be attractive or repulsive. That depends on the nature of two point charges, but gravitational force is always attractive in nature. That is the difference between Coulomb force and gravitational force. The second one is gravitational force is not affected by the material medium. Electrostatic force between two charges depends on the material medium. That means electrostatic force is not universal because it depends on the presence of intervening medium between two point charges, but the gravitational force is universal force because it does not depend on the presence of the intervening medium between two particles. Electrostatic force that is much stronger than the gravitational force, that is approximately 10 to 38 times. Electrostatic force is much stronger than the gravitational force. Thank you.